We have the following automaton grill given, and we are asked to write down a right linear grammar that describes the same language as the automaton does. And that's what I want to show you in this video. And if you remember, if you have a grammar, then a grammar consists of non-terminals, or sometimes called variables, terminals, some production rules, and a start symbol. Now, if in this method, when we have the set of non-terminals, we say that the set of non-terminals is just the set of the states in the automaton. So in this case, we have one non-terminal Q0 for the initial state, Q1 for that state, and Q2 for the last state. And we don't need anything else besides it. And the terminals that are just the input symbols that you can see at the arcs. So we just have A and B and nothing else. And that's just the same set as we use in the grammar. And we have the start symbol, and that's just the same as the initial state in our automaton. So in this case, it's Q0. Now the interesting part are the production rules. That's what we want to write down now. And maybe if you remember, when you have a right linear grammar, that means on the left-hand side of a rule you have a non-terminal, and on the right-hand side of the rule you have a terminal and a non-terminal. And that's a right linear grammar because you always process the rightmost non-terminal, and well, if you do a derivation for a word and you just have one non-terminal that you have to produce. And that's if you imagine you have one non-terminal that you can produce, that's nearly the same as if you are in the same state in an automaton. That's what I try to make you clear in a number of examples. So we are in the initial state, or in the start, or we begin with a start symbol, that's Q0. And, well, if you can see here, if you are in Q0 and you want to you can process an input symbol B, and you will return to Q0. And that's just the same in the grammar as if you are in Q0. You process those exactly input symbol, in this case the B, and you return to the input symbol. So just imagine that those input symbols and states are nearly the same, or are analogous to each other, or something like that. So if we, so that arc is the same as this rule in the grammar that we want to create. So let's just have a look at the next arc. That's this one where you have to, where you are in Q0 and you read an input symbol and you move to Q1. So in the grammar, that's in the grammar, it's the same as if you are in Q0, or if you can do the next derivation step with the Q0, and you read an A as input symbol, and you move to Q1. So the grammar just works the same as the automaton, as you can see here. The next arc is this one, where we begin in Q1 and we read a B and we move to Q1. So we are in Q1, we read that input symbol B, and we move again to Q1. So the next ones I have to write beside it, but it doesn't matter because the order doesn't matter in the production rules because we have a set here. So the next arc, well, let's take this one where we are in Q1, reading an A as an input symbol and moving to Q2. That's like we are in Q1, And we read, or we generate an A as input symbol, and we move to Q2. And the next one, let's take this one, where we are in Q2, reading a B, and again move to Q2. So we are in Q2. Read, so, or generate, in this case, those B as input symbol. Well, as you can see, the grammar and the automaton, where the automaton processes and inputs input symbols or consumes input symbols, and the grammar generates one, but they both describe the same language, as you can see here. So that was this arc, and we have one arc left. When we are in Q2, we can read an input symbol and move to Q1. And in a production rule, it would be the same as if we have a Q2 and we want to do a derivation step and generate an A and move to Q1. So, but we are not done yet, because Q2 is our final state, and at this moment, those grammar can't derive any words, because it will never end a derivation. So what we have to do next is that we want to make sure that when we have when we are in the automaton in the final state, then we are done. And if we are in the same situation in our grammar, we want to be done as well. And there are several methods to do it. Let me just give you two possibilities. One possibility is that you can just add Q2 expense to the empty string, because, let's take an example. If you are in Q1 and you read an A, and you are in Q2 and say maybe those A is just the last symbol in your word, then you are done. And if you do the same with this rule, or with Q1, and you, oh yeah, with this rule, then you generate those input symbol, and if you derive Q2 to the empty string, then it's just the same. But the problem with this rule is that it depends on your definition if those rule is allowed. Because some definitions say that only rules of a form like that are accepted in a right linear grammar, and those are just sometimes allowed and not always. So sometimes you can just add that rule, but it depends on a definition. And if it's not possible, then, let me just write it like this. If those rules are not allowed, you can do some other thing. I write it in green. Then you have to take all rules where you can move to Q2 and just handle it as if Q2 would be empty. So for that rule, you just add, write it a little bit higher. For that rule, you add Q1 expense to just A. And you imagine that, when Q2 expense to the empty word, it's just the same as if Q1 would have been derived to the A just in one step. So it's just the same. And the other rule where we have Q2 on the right hand side is this one, and for that you would have to add Q2 expense to B. Sometime you are done if you considered all arcs in the automaton and wrote those transitions for it, and if you handled all final states, whether with this, if it's allowed, or by exchanging every non-terminal that's like that has the same name as the final state and replace it by nothing in every rule where it occurs, then you have the grammar that accepts the same language as your automaton.